Well, now it's actually Black Friday, and there are a couple things that I want to check out and see if there are good deals on a few things in particular. So we're gonna head out and go explore for a bit. So what did I buy, you may ask? Well, so I've had this setup, the ultra wide monitor, for a while. And I really like the monitor because it's got lots of real estate and it's really, really good. But everything I shoot now is entirely in, hold on. Everything I shoot now is entirely in 4K, and so I've been having my laptop down here next to it to be able to like see in a higher quality than 1080. This is only 1080, so a lot of screen real estate, but not necessarily quality, especially when you're doing pictures and all that. So I've been wanting to get like a 4K monitor that I can really use as my main monitor, and I wanted something pretty big, but I didn't want ultra wide because I actually want to put the laptop next to it now instead of in front of it, because it just works out better for what I'm doing. So I found a really good deal on this one. This is what I'm thinking. Even though I had just changed my desk setup. I'm liking this, I think. Pretty much digging it. It's new, something different. Try it out. I think I gotta mess with some color though, because it looks pretty wacky right now. But so that makes sense from the standpoint of I want 4K rather than ultra wide for now, just because I need a better quality viewing monitor alongside of mine, so that makes sense. Now, the next thing, we're about to turn to a very different topic, and this one probably is not gonna make very much sense to you. This one, let me try to explain this the best way I can. So as you know, I have had the GH5 for a bunch of months, and I really, really like it. Everything about it is, well, not everything about it, which is part of the reason why we decided to make little bit of an adjustment. So as you know, we recently have started to offer photography, but alongside of photography, there's also a couple things here and there that the GH5 doesn't do so well, like autofocus, which is a given. It's fine for everyday vlogs, it's fine for everyday usage, but there are certain areas that we have realized that it's not as ideal as we'd prefer, because when it comes to tracking a bride down the aisle or any of those kind of things, it's just not always perfect. Most important, from a photography standpoint, we decided we definitely don't like the GH5 for photography. You don't really like the Micro Four Thirds format at all for photography. I'm not even crazy about it for video, to be honest, but I can do with it. But what we do like a lot for photography are Sony's. Now, obviously, there's a new A7S III coming out. There's an A9 that just came out. There's an A7 R3 that's just out. There are a lot of great cameras that are coming out or have just come out already. We wanted a camera that we knew we were going to utilize and have a lot of use for, regardless whether something new and crazy exciting came out. We wanted there to still be the cameras that we were going to have to be useful. So we purchased all this stuff. This is the Sony 70-200. We had this lens before. And the Sony 16-35, another terrific lens, had this lens as well. So what body? This one's a little surprising, but it's for good reason. Sony A6500 is back in the shop. Now, before you say, wait, what in the world? You're getting rid of the GH5s for the A6500? No, but the A6500 does a few things extremely well. One of them being ridiculous autofocus, and the other one being it's a very, very good camera for photography. It's a really small form factor body, but still very powerful. It's also a really, really good vlog camera that, depending on what I do with lenses and things for the GH5, it can be a really, really good supplemental camera. The thought process is we definitely are gonna get rid of one of the GH5s. We don't need three of them if we obviously have some sort of secondary camera like the A6500 or something different than that. And the main uses of the A6500 are going to be autofocus and gimbal work, because we want a camera that really is dedicated to have really good autofocus for gimbal work, and also just a really small, easy to throw around on a gimbal. We want something that's very easy for that, and the A6500 is fantastic for those two things. So you might be saying to yourself, like, well, aren't you a GlideCam fan? You've always had that. You don't even have a gimbal until today. It's never been an issue of whether I was a fan of gimbals, because I think gimbals are great and they're really useful. The problem with gimbals is there's always inconveniences with them, because you can't set them down and the battery life isn't great and it's just bulky and hard to use all the time. And the Zhiyun Crane 2. What makes this thing so unique is that a lot of the things that I don't like about gimbals were solved in this little handheld gimbal. I don't like the fact that you can't set gimbals down. Well, this gimbal has feet that you can set it down. I don't like the fact that you have to worry about battery life, because I don't want to have to charge another battery or have to carry around more than one battery all the time. Well, this one has 18-hour battery life, which is a lot. And I don't really like the fact that they're bulky and hard to carry around and swap cameras out on, and this solves that too, because it's tiny. And it also comes with a case. So in other words, what I'm trying to say is, I think this is actually gonna be really, really cool. That they finally realized that it's annoying to carry around a gimbal because you can't set it down. So they smartly said, well, why don't we solve that? And they made feet. So you can set it down on the ground. And this one actually has additional controls to be able to control aperture and even focus pulling depending on the camera you're using. I don't think that works with a Sony, but I'm just really excited about this. It seems awesome. So to recap, first of all, we are selling one of the GH5s. And it's not at all about that we don't like the GH5s. We really love them and they are everything that we really want from a camera, and they work great for so many aspects. The problem is, over the course of using them for half the wedding season or more than half the wedding season, we've realized that we do really want one camera that has really, really good autofocus. It's very important to us, because for the main shots where we're tracking a bride coming down the aisle, or where it's on a gimbal and we're getting shots of them kissing and hanging out and doing their thing that we usually film on a gimbal, we like to make sure that it's in focus and that it just does its own job of being in focus, so we don't have to worry about it. So it made a lot of sense from our standpoint to get an A6500, and then on top of that, we wanted a secondary camera that was really the one that we would use for photography, the one that would always be our go-to photography camera until we really decided on what main body we wanted to use for it. Pablo already has one, so that's another big selling point. Then now we have two GH5s and two A6500s for our company, so when we do photo jobs, Pablo and I both have an A6500 already. It didn't cost me a lot more to just get another one, and after I sell the GH5 and some lenses with that, it'll just be a pretty good even trade. So the A6500 will be on a gimbal primarily, that'll be its main purpose, but then during a ceremony we'll throw a 7200 on it, or we will throw on a 24-105, which we're still gonna purchase, and then have this be the main camera that tracks the bride coming down the aisle, and then the rest of it, we really will depend on what we're shooting, but the gimbal will always have this on it, and I just think it makes a lot of sense. And the photography jobs, this will be the main camera, and I just think it's gonna work out really well. All right, I got the gimbal working. Let's give it a shot. Okay, so we're fast forwarding about 25 minutes, and I already changed it all back. I didn't like that monitor I got. Number one, I did not like the quality of it at all, and I also didn't like the way that it was set up, and it had to block my speakers, and then I was gonna have to get speaker stands to go on this. That was like the shortest lived setup I ever had, and I'm actually back to like square one. The computer's laptop is closed, I'm back to just using the ultra wide and back to using one monitor. Who knows how long this will last, but. So did I buy the A6500 to replace the GH5? No, that was not the goal at all. It is replacing one of the GH5s and I am selling one of the GH5s, but it's not because I just am not happy with the GH5s anymore. It's more that I think that instead of having a GH5 as a third camera that I use so sparingly, and more importantly, when I do use it, that is there a better camera for those specific uses that I could have? And the answer is yes. The answer is the fact that the third camera at a wedding is designed to shoot the bride coming down the aisle and the people coming down the aisle. And so it just makes sense to have a camera that has outstanding autofocus for that, because that's what its main use is. And if I can make more use out of the A6500 because of photography and because of the lenses that I really like from Sony and the picture profiles I really like for photography, this now gives me a better option, and instead of just sacrificing and having a third camera for video that's not really the best use for that, now I can have kind of a good all-around camera. And then regardless what decisions we make for 2018, whether we stick with the GH5s or whether we go a different route, this still will be a great camera for either way, because the A6500 is a phenomenal little camera for video and it's a phenomenal little camera for photography. It just really depends on what you want. I wouldn't use these as my main cameras because they do have overheating issues, they have some reliability issues. They're not the greatest cameras in the entire world, but for what we're going to use them for, they're actually a fantastic little camera, and it also would be a great camera for me to vlog with because it's just really tiny and small and it's got great autofocus. That's just a no-brainer. But most of you are probably saying, my goodness, you change cameras and stuff more than anyone I've ever seen, and the answer is you're absolutely right. But that's gonna do it for today. Thanks for watching. Hope you had a fantastic Black Friday. If you bought some, there goes my light again. I gotta change the battery. If you bought some exciting things on Black Friday, I would love to hear what you bought. And if you were one of the people that signed up for Tave, which I know a bunch of you already have, you're gonna love it. And please tell me what you think of it, because I'm excited to hear more about how great it's working for you. So, I'll see you soon. Have a good one.